Welcome! In this video, I would like to guide you through the first couple of steps which needs to be done when you buy a camera from adaptive recognition. So without further ado, let's begin! If you already bought a VIDAR camera, this packaging should be familiar to you. The box contains the camera itself, a bracket, which is responsible for the safe physical installation, screws, and a size 3 Allen key for the bracket, and also a quick install guide which guides you on how to start using your VIDAR product. Of course, it can contain some cables as well, if you order them directly from us. If you order cables, you can choose from three types of cables. The first is the power cable, which is used to power up the camera. Next is the Ethernet cable, which is responsible for the network connection, and also a 12-pin GPIO cable, which can be used to connect an external illuminator, a radar, or any third-party device to the camera. As an optional accessory, we sell external illuminators if the built-in illuminator is not enough for you. Then we have junction boxes to connect any third-party device to the camera, and radar modules as well, which is used when certified speed measurement is needed. If you need to install the camera with its bracket, you will need to connect it to the camera. First, you need to fix the turning ball's position with a size 5 Allen key. Then, prepare the given screws and the size 3 Allen key alongside with the rubber sealing. The screws should go into the smaller holes and the rubber sealing between the camera and the bracket. Then, screw the bracket into the bottom of the camera with all four screws. If you're ready, the camera could be installed with the bracket into a real environment. Let's start the assembling with the power cable. For demo purposes, we are using a standard 24-volt AC power supply with splicing connectors. Please note that we do not sell power sources for our cameras, however, you can find some recommendations in the description of this video. You can see that the wired side of the cable contains two red and two black-ended cables. These must be connected in pairs, the red with the red, and the black with the black. Then, the connector side should go directly into the middle connector in the camera's back. It is indicated on the back of the camera with a little power icon as well. Drive in the cable fully, and then the power cable in its place. We will continue with the Ethernet cable. On one end, it has an RJ45 Ethernet connector, while the other end has an X-coded connector, which should go directly into the camera. Just as like the power connector, it is indicated in the backside of the camera with a little network icon. You need to drive in that as well, and make sure that the connection is not loose. If you bought a radar or an external illuminator from us, or you just want to use a different third-party device to connect into the camera, you will need a 12-pin GPIO cable. This must go into the remaining connector on the back side of the camera. Now, the cables are connected. The last two steps is to connect the Ethernet cable to a laptop or a switch first, then plug the power supply into the power socket. This will turn on the camera. Once the camera started booting, you will hear a little motoric sound and a couple of LEDs will lighten up in the front side of the device. Both red and green light will light up, then the green flashes two times and the red lights out. This means that the camera is booted safely and it's ready for operation. You can find all the necessary informations in the description of this video down below.